Thank you. friends, I greet you in the powerful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I hope you can hear me. It seems like it's a bit low. Okay. Friends, as we gather this afternoon, we just want to start by acknowledging that there are those of us who are gathered in this space, in this sanctuary, but there are those who are also joining with us in this special service through social media and on YouTube. And so we acknowledge those who are joining us. My name is Spiwe Mati, and I am going to be helping to hold the service together this afternoon. The first thing that we just want to mention and to announce is the fact that when we were planning for this service, and we met, the latest was yesterday, really, when we met to plan for this service, we were planning a service to celebrate and honor the life of the Reverend Themba Mntambo. And when we were planning the service, one of the things that we said was that we would like this session to be a celebration and to carry with it a celebratory mood as we celebrate his life, but also the things that he appreciated in life. And one of those things, we know that it is good music. But then, as we all know, that we can plan, but ultimately it is God's purposes that gets fulfilled. And so as we were planning, God's plan was something else for us as we gather. And so as we gather now this afternoon, we gather having received the news that our dearly beloved Reverend Themba Mntambo is no longer with us. He has gone to be with the Lord. And so we decided together with the family that we will still continue with this service, and this is not a memorial service. We would still like this service to be a service that celebrates, but of course we can no longer now celebrate as if we have not received the news that we have received. And so as we continue with this service, we acknowledge that we come with the tension of holding different emotions, and as we do so, I just invite you that be mindful of the fact that we are in the house of the Lord. And so whatever emotions that are evoked during this service, just know that we are in the presence of God. And so feel free to express those emotions in whatever way that you feel led to express those emotions. And so in a sense, senza lanto kwaXhosa kuthiwa ukwamukela umphanga. At the same time, we continue with the other program that we had planned. And so as we go through the program for today, you will sense that there is that tension between those various aspects. Having said that, today was primarily going to be about celebrating his life through music. And so we've got that wonderful team that will be leading us with music throughout. And so we encourage you to enjoy the music as much as you can under the circumstances. But before we get to that, I'm going to invite Mfundisi Bosman to lead us in a call to worship. And then after that, Mfundisi Makanda will lead us in the Lord's Prayer. And then immediately after that, I'm going to ask Reverend David Fiedler to come and welcome us.
Thank you very much, Reverend Madi. Friends, can we please stand and observe a moment of silence? Amen. We follow you, Jesus, today as we worship in words of love and devotion sung and spoken, in service and kindness, in shared life and sacred meal. And all we need to do to follow you as we leave this place is to continue saying and doing to others what we bring to you in this hour. And so we pray for praise and affirmation to empower our families and communities, for confession and forgiveness, to reconcile personal and national enemies, and lead us into integrity and goodness. We pray for thanksgiving and generosity to cover our greed and overcome poverty. We think of Psalm 90, which says in isiXhosa, Nkosi wabalikhaya lethu isizukulwana ngesizukulwana zingekazalwa intaba ungekadali umhlaba nelizwe kwangona phakade kude kube ngunaphakade wena unguThixo. Uyamguqulela entshabalaleni umntu uthi buyelani bonyana babantu ngokuba ebusweni bakho iwaka leminyaka linjengezolo xa ligqithileyo nanjengomlindo ebusuku. Uyabakhukhulisa banjengobuthongo, kusasa banjengengca ehlumayo, kusasa iyatyatyamba ihlume, ngokuhlwa iyasikwa ibune. Ngokuba sigqithwa ngengqumbo yakho, siyakhwankqiswa ngomsindo wakho. Inkohlakalo zethu uzibekile phambi kwakho, izono zethu ezifihlakeleyo uzibekile ekukhanyeni kobuso bakho. Ngokuba yonke imihla yethu idlula emsindweni wakho, siyagqiba iminyaka yethu njengembali. Imihla yeminyaka yethu iminyaka emashumi asixhenxe, nanxa ithi ngenxa yokomelela ibe iminyaka emashumi asibhozo, amandla ayo abubunzima nobubi noko. Ngokuba yanqanyulwa kamsinya, size sibaleke. Kubani na owazi amandla engqumbo yakho, nomsindo wakho ngokuyikeka kwakho. Sazise ukubala imihla yethu, ukuze sizuze intliziyo elumkileyo. Buya Yehova, kodwa kade kangakanani na, uze ube nosizi phezu kwethu thina zicaka zakho. Sikholise kusasa ngobubele bakho, ize sigcobe sivuye yonke imihla yethu. Sivuyise njengokwemihla wabusibandezele ngayo, njengokweminyaka sabe sibona ububi ngayo. Makubonakale izenzo zakho ezicakeni zakho, nobungcwalisa bakho kubantwana bazo. Mabuthi ubuhle bukaYehova uThixo wethu bube phezu kwethu, nomsebenzi wezandla zethu uqinise phezu kwethu. Ewe, umsebenzi wezandla zethu uqinise. As we forgive
temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the
Please be seated.
Thank you, Rev Bosman. A warm welcome to each and every single one of you, to our bishop who has been navigating with the family over the last couple of weeks that Rev Themba was ill, to the family who now get to say farewell. I know we are sad tonight, but I pray that the music moves us from a space of sadness to a space of joy, knowing that Rev Themba is with his God. And so welcome to each of you. Please feel free, there's going to be lyrics on the screen if you know the song. Please join in. If you can't sing like me, you might not want to join in. But please feel and make yourself at home. Thank you.
Shadows come, and why should my heart feel lonely? And long for heaven. When Jesus is my portion, a constant His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Thank you. Themba Mntambo, Yehova,
Yehova,
no.
Oh,
Come, let us pray. O God of all grace and all mercies, O God from whom we come and to whom we shall return at the end of our life on earth, O God who has created, who continues to create, who will forever be creative, we worship you, we honor you, we bless your holy name. Your name is above every other name, for at the mention of your name, every knee bows, of all beings in heaven and on earth, all beings under the waters. For your name creates and your name transforms. So this evening we pray to you, O God, in thanksgiving for the life you have given us, in thanksgiving for the people you have given to us to live this life together with, in thanksgiving for family and friends, thanksgiving for everything that you have provided for us in order to live this life meaningfully. But above all, we give thanks to you for this, your servant, our brother, our father, our dear minister, Reverend Themba Mntambo. We give thanks to you for his life and his ministry. We give thanks to you for the many souls you have touched through his witness. We give thanks to you for the joys we have shared together with him and the sorrows we have endured together with him. We give thanks for the towering figure that he was. And we pray in the name of Jesus that the image of the vibrant, ever laughing, joking Themba will never be removed from our eyes. We give thanks to you that it was in your will that you called him first and foremost to be a disciple of Jesus, to follow you in as best a way as he could, a way that may not have been perfect at times, but a way in which he could, a way in which he knew how best to follow you. We thank you for his call, for your call upon his life, to enter into the ministry of word and sacrament, and through that ministry to touch many communities and societies throughout this connection and beyond. And we thank you for the witness that he shared with those to whom he ministered and those with whom he had an encounter. And we give thanks to you for the love he shared with his family up until the last moment of his life. For all these things, O God, were used by you to witness to the world about how much you love the world. For Brother Themba, the love of God was not just a theory to be shared. It was a way of life, which impacted many. And so we thank you for his love, and we thank you for his witness. And now we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you would teach us to accept your will. Sometimes your will is confusing. Sometimes your will is not easy to accept. Sometimes your will we struggle with. But Lord, teach us to accept your will. Teach us to know that your will is always for the good of humanity, for the good of creation, for the good of those who love you, for the good of those who believe in you. Teach us to accept your will. And teach us now to reflect upon his life and in giving thanks to bring this family to you. We bring Siskidi and the children and the grandchildren and the entire family to you. Lord, may your promises be fulfilled in them at this time. I am not leaving you alone. I am not leaving you as orphans. My Father will send to you the Holy Spirit who will comfort you. Fear not, I am with you. You are mine. I have called you by name. Even if you go through rivers, they will not sweep over you. Even if you walk through fires, they will not quench you. May these promises be true now in the Mntambo family. But more so, may your love ever embrace them. May those to whom Brati has ministered find your comfort as well. And allow us to rejoice in you, even at this time. Give us grace to know that he is with you. And receive his soul into your eternal keeping. And may your perpetual light ever shine upon him. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
It is the Apostle Paul who reminds us that whether we live or whether we die, we belong to God. And he continues to say, in death and in life, we are the Lord's. God is good all the time. Let's try this again. And now let's try to internalize it. God is good all the time. Thank you. Friends, I am going to call Ubabuzweli Mntambo to come and address us. And I'm going to ask Umfundisi Makhanda to lead us in one of our indigenous Sotho hymns as Ubaba Mntambo comes forward. Over to you.
Jesus, kaya ba tutuole ra tu sebeti ona kena che o bito.
Lache Amen. You may be seated.
Dear friends, members of family, members of this church in this part of the world, and the whole of the connection of the Methodists in South Africa, Southern Africa and the world. I simply stand here to thank you for the many prayers and thoughts that you've had with us over these last 3 weeks. There have been countless messages, countless words of comfort and prayer, and they're still flowing in. I guess for me, over these last 3 weeks, there's something that I understood better, which is, how do you define family? Because there's a time when we were in the deepest space in the first week of my brother being hospital. Messages were sent to say, please give family time to gather and make sense of what is going on. And my brother, Bishop Mokgotu, said, he calls me Brazweli, I call him Brasid. Found a way of trying to get us to recognize what we were going through by asking us to have this prayer service 2 weeks ago. And now, later on, we decided that it might be time to try and wake up my brother who was lying in hospital through music, because he loves music. And before I go any further, let me say this prayer service is a tribute. It is a message of hope. It is a message of healing. So whilst at some point we were trying to heal who was lying in hospital chamber, today we are healing him and we are healing us and those who are online and elsewhere in the world. So this is a prayer, a moment of music and prayer to create healing for all of us. So I'd like to acknowledge the support of that I got and we got as a family from the church. Ntate Mokgotu, I must say, you did much more than, now I understand why I didn't want to become bishop. I saw it with my brother, I saw it with you. One evening, we're trying to pull things together, and he says, my brother, I'm just going into a meeting. It's about 7:30 p.m. And I say, but you know, I need to talk to you urgently. He says, yeah, I'll come back to you. And then the meeting goes on forever, and I say to him, well, I'm now going to bed. I'm texting him. I'm going to bed, I'll talk to you tomorrow. And of course, tomorrow he came and said, Mrur, I'm very sorry. Couldn't come back to you. So under those circumstances of working as hard as you've done, my brother, I really would like to pass our thanks as family and my own personal thanks, having known you with Themba all of these many years. In the same vein, I'd like to thank all of the ministers of this church and many others in this part of the world who knew Themba. And this church has been our family. And so it was difficult to say what is family, because this family is so broad, it is so wide. As I understood it, the district of Limpopo stretches into Botswana, or used to, until not long ago. So my brother would call me and say, I'm off to Francistown. I say, what are you doing there? He says, no, I'm going to minister in Francistown in Botswana. At times you'll go to Mpumalanga and be in many other parts of the world, Swaziland. So forth. So we understood the work that he had to do. Having acknowledged the church and the Machalis district, Reverend Jaco Gerber, sitting in the back there, Mr. David Fiedler, who worked with us to pull this together, Vuvukile Makhanda, now Mfundisi, and many others, by the way. I would not be able to mention each one by name, but we really appreciate what support that you're giving us, giving to us. And my dear sister Kidiboni, you've been my pillar as well, because as it was going tough, you stood up and gave us strength. And as it was going tough for you, some of us stood up and gave you strength. And we'd like to thank you for the many, many years that you spent looking after our brother and looking after each other. I do know that he's cooked very many good meals for you. He sent us pictures of what he was cooking from time to time. Manjing Abanuguti, after his retirement, he's got a new career, which is head chef in the home. He even bakes scones, am I right? Now, I can't bake half a scone in my life, but my brother did. So, me, li bana, especially Mntambo, seated right behind you. Neo, is Neo here? I don't see. Okay, he's going to fetch your sister. Neo stood firm and was helpful, but I can't thank Mntambo enough for all of the work that she's done, staying with her mother day and night, hour after hour. Lynn, now when I had a need for something to be done to a certain point, I would know who to turn to, and that was Mntambo. So thank you, my sister. Ongwana, actually, you're not my sister. You're my child. Girata Holeba, all of the children. In particular, the Banaba Abuti, Unandipa Mntambo, who spoke the other day when we were here together. Uthembalezwe Mntambo, who is the second born. Nopumla Mntambo, last born. Now, we were with the three of them at the hospital, because when I got the message to say things are not looking good, I dropped everything that I could and I tried to be at the hospital as soon as possible. And the children came and joined. What I found most heartening was that they said, we want to wait for our sister Nandipa, who was traveling from Rustenburg. And the three of us as children want to spend time with Dad. And we gave them that time. And they have found a way of connecting in their own way with their father. Size sabashiya esibhedlela. Sabuya ukuthi size la kwi-service. I believe where they are trying to bind each other together and bind the wounds of losing a father. So they are not here with us at this point in time. But bantwana bam, just know that's intent. Now, good our musicians, la. I won't name them by name. But when I thought together with the bishop about could we do this prayer service and include the music from people like them, I have my go-to guy. His name is James Ngobo, Mapoloba. James, une direct line ga Babu Mngoma, Tsepo Mngoma. Tsepo, opagame bakubone kahle. Tsepo lo, yeah. He's the music director. So James can't direct music, from what I know. But Tsepo can. So thank you, Tsepo, for leading us and being so agile to do this at fairly short notice, and that when we changed a bit of tech to say we are just going to come for a healing service, and now my brother is moved on, I said to the priests and the church, don't worry. Those guys will do it. They'll pull it off. So thank you very much. You will have the duty of introducing the rest of the music group. You know, Ansilo Mutuku was introduced to that, who was Chelwood on piano, and so on and so forth. But I love the music that they play. There was a time when I was traveling back from our homestead in Madinyani 2 Sundays ago, and a song by Roberta Flack and Donny Hathaway came onto my Apple Music station. They were singing the song, Come Ye Disconsolate. And I know the song from a long time, and it reminded me that this is the kind of song that me and Themba would enjoy listening to. Because they, both Roberta Flack and Donny Hathaway, and I'm speaking to people who are in the United States, Eileen, I hope you're online with people in Washington, D.C., who will understand what I'm talking about. So there are times when you listen to music and you hear the voices. But there are times when you listen to the music and you hear only one particular instrument or two. And on this occasion, in that song, there was a piano that was being played in the most amazing way. So I immediately called James and I said, James, do you know anybody who can hit a piano? I didn't say play a piano. Who can hit a piano? So he immediately understood what I meant. I said, yeah, there's this song and so forth. I would like it to be the place, the song around which we hang on what we're trying to do. And full stop, you do the rest. And because people like Donny Hathaway and Roberta Flack and others can combine a number of genres in their repertoire of moving from gospel to jazz to blues and I don't know whatever else. So as you listen to this song, it brings all of those things together in one place. So we're not going to really be playing jazz, don't worry. But there will be jazz in the music somewhere. So my brother loved music, and he still loves music, by the way, because he is alive in the presence of God. He is away from us. He is alive in the presence of God. So in that sense, we'll also speak about him in the present tense, not in the past tense. So he loves music. And I know one of the things is that he knew what I call the sight and sound of good music. Now, I don't know whether you can have the sight of good music, but my brother did. He knew the sight and sound of good music. Now, ngizonitshela abantu besonto from time to time, kuti, on a Sunday afternoon, or whenever we get to meet and have a braai with my brother at his house and so on, he would have come from some service or other, as he would every Sunday, and say, yazi labantu. Hey man, the organist, and so, they were off key. And you'd be so worried about the fact that they didn't get the key right. They were off key, tingling about Vusa man, I totally learned. So some of us, we do it off key, a little bit off key, sometimes a lot. So the voice that I have and Themba has comes from our dad. My dad was never off key, but my mother was more than half the time off key. So Harliko Kereking and so on, and Tswanse Mutwanse Sefila would play that it's not our mother. Oh, but her heart is in the right place, but the key is not quite the right one. So I hope you guys have got the keys right. Oskiri Boni, when I talked about the piano, I called and said, do you guys have a piano? She says, yeah, we have a piano. I said, are you sure? Yeah, he says, there's a piano that gets played from time to time in the church. I said, are you sure, sure, sure? I said, oh. So I said, no, okay. Just give me the guy who plays that piano. The name of the guy. Is it Lee? Lee. So I want to speak to Lee. I said, Lee, you have a piano? He says, yes, I have a piano. I said, Lee, tell me. Does the piano really, really do this stuff? He says, yeah, it plays. Then I interrogate him a bit further because I know some things about, these notes and that. says, but yeah, there are some notes when you really have to, like, you know, force them to happen. I said, that's not the one. Yeah. Oskiboni, thank you very much for the offer of your church piano. We brought a grand piano to play the music and the notes that Themba would love to hear. And thank you for doing what you're doing on the piano. Thank you. Now, to Eileen and the team in the United States of America, I don't know what part you are, but I do know that you and Themba and other ministers brought a lot of students from the US, young pastors, to be brought into how we do things in this part of the world. And I know that you're all very concerned and feeling the pain that we are feeling even over the Atlantic. That distance is not as much as geography makes it, because we are with you, we are together. And I trust that the music that we're providing today, because Eileen, I'm told that you are a serious musician, can I put it that way, that you will enjoy with us the time here in this service. As I work towards concluding what I would say, there are many of you who ask the question, what happened to Themba? Now, because I've already defined all of us as family, Themba suffered a brain hemorrhage, which was a very serious one. Sometimes these hemorrhages go and maybe don't go into the brain and stay, I don't know what the term is, subcutaneous or something like that. But this time the brain, the blood went into the brain itself, or sensitive parts of the brain. And in order to do that, to remove that blood, is a mammoth of a task for any surgeon. So they drained as much blood as they could. And of course, because it was so extensive, the brain swells and it comes down and so on. There are blood clots that get left somewhere and have to be worked on. And procedure after procedure after procedure. We won't go into all of them. I know him, we know him to be a fighter in spirit and in his being. He fought a good fight in getting himself to help the doctors to take him to where he needed to be. Just as we thought maybe there is a chance, things complicate. This world we live in is not known by us, because there is a prayer that says, may that peace of God that surpasses all understanding be with us in Jesus' name. It must guard our hearts and mind. Is that what it says? So there is an understanding that we do not have, that is only understood and known by the one who has made and created us. And we should let Themba be with his maker, because all of these years that he has been around, and I haven't counted, but it's well over 40 years, if not 45. Remembering him as a young recruit priest, Emadinyani, Palama Bicycle, Aloisa Diplani, Komadiji, Likokai, Likokai. So he's journeyed with his God on this part of the side of life. He's continuing to journey with God on that part of life where God has called him to. So we must be comforted in the sense that akusilo muntu obekumgedeni obezenza ngathi uyamthanda uThixo kodwa engamthandi. Ithi may say shonile bese khona sikhalayo sithi oh umuntu uNkulunkulu kanjani kanjani. This man knows what he's been about between him and his God. And we will simply have to accept that was God's will. Simkulule, simkhulule emoyeni yethu nemzimbini yethu senqondweni zethu ukuthi uhambele phambili uyohlangana nabazali bakhe nogogo wakhe nokhokho, that those ancestors have also paved the way for him and for us. So ke ngiyacela ke ukuthi noma it is at short notice noma kanjani inhliziyo zethu masikhululeke. Now, the song that I would like the group to play is the one that talks about "Come Ye Disconsolate." But it is us who are coming to be consoled, to console ourselves, and to console others. So let that peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, let it guard our hearts and minds. In Jesus Christ, amen.
Oh, not cure. I said, oh,
I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We'd like to take this opportunity also just to say condolences to the family. Clearly, we are celebrating a great worshiper here. Hallelujah. And he is now in the heavens, worshiping with our Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. So I just want to take this opportunity, as Themba Mntambo has asked me, to introduce the ensemble. On my far left is Usis Nokanya Dlamini. Next to her is Usisi Utiti Luzipo. On organ and second keys, we have Mr. S.B. Muilwa. And on the piano, busy hammering on the piano there, Mr. Mpo Kodisan. Thank you so, so much. Now we're going to go back to Ms. Titi Luzipo doing.
How I got over, how I got over, you know my soul, look back and wonder how I got over, how I got over. Here, I want to thank God.
Oh, sorry.
There's only one thing that I forgot to mention. Thank you. Our parents, my parents are here. I just want to acknowledge your presence in the journey that you have made us travel. Matebulali, Auntie, they are here. And it would have been remiss of me not to acknowledge them. And it was remiss of me to do that. Our elder sister, Themba Mntambo, Kolekulu, is also here. My own children and my nephews and nieces are also here, and many other friends. I think it's important that I should acknowledge all of you. Now, one little thing, you know, Sister Pini, once had a brain operation. So we're going through this for the second time round. So she was admitted to Pretoria Hospital, East Hospital, I think it's called. And then, so obviously, I mean, you know, Abantu Omnyama, where have you seen Kopa Bomuntu Buvulwa? So we were very worried, obviously, when they said they wanted to remove some or other matter in her brain, her brain tumor. So the brain works. So I remember the day when me and Themba, in the evening, the operation was going to be the very next early morning. We went there, and between the two of us, we were saying, could this be the last time we speak to our sister? As usual, Themba prayed in the manner that I described last time, that him and God can quite connect through his method of prayer. When we came back the next day, we looked at my sister. It didn't look like she was ever going to come back to life. And she did. But she had told us before the operation, which means, "Nyabuya." We said, well, this is the usual bravery that we know, but this one is serious, you know. So thank you very much, and please continue with the lovely renditions that you're busy with. Thank you.
Tingle and do miss.
Bunzulu,
ngosi mawuthuni swengosi tuni swengo si kuse pa gade.
Been ministered to. It is good to be here. I feel like one of the disciples when they were at a certain mountain with Jesus, and God revealed God's self to them. And as they experienced the wonder and the beauty of being in the presence of the Lord, one of them said to Jesus, "It is good to be here. I wish that we could be here for longer. How about we pitch some tents so that we are here for longer?" And so, Putsepo, I know this is supposed to be your last set. Mina ke ngumfana sethokoza. Ethokoza sinikosheta yonke into. Singabumashaya yonke into siyakwazi ukuthi sithole indlela yokuyilungisa. So may I ask that we give them a round of applause. And that round of applause babuzweli ile nto sithi grace. And so Pratsepo, may I ask if it's possible, I'm going to call somebody who's going to lead us in a prayer, and then Umfundisi Makhanda will lead us in a song as we call the bishop to address us. And then after the bishop has addressed us, if possible, uzangihlebele, please, nike nisithinte nje futhi ukugcina after lapho. Siyabonga. May I invite Mem Ujaji to come and lead us in a prayer.
Ntate le kana go ena e re leng ho yona re tlisa tlhompho le poko go wena go bane di a go tshwanela ntate amohela moya wa mora wa hao o mmileditseng go wena go bane nako ene e se fihlile Modimo o lokileng re a leboha ntate re a leboha. Dingata ga ka nthotse re tshwanetseng re di leboge thapameng ya letsatsi la kajeno empa ha re na o di qeta Jehova gobane dingata o ne o le teng Modimo o lokileng ha batswadi ba mo isa kerekeng jwale ka Samuele ho binwa sefela se reng bitso la ka kajeno o le ngole le sekebe la tloga bukeng tsa gago mme ga nako ya gago e fitlha ntate o nthole re a leboga morena gore nako ya gago ga e fitlha o mothotse moo aila are o tla mo fumana teng o na santsane a dutsi Jehova a hetsa mosebetsi o motle wa hao dingata hakakang ntho tse re ka dipuang ka yena empa ho ba dingata ha re na diqeta ntate re a leboha re ne re le teng ha ne a re laela mosebetsing a re ke ya hae ke lo phumula ke qetile mosebetsi o ne modimo a batla hore ke etse le ha na tseba hore o santsane le mongata mosebetsi o ba nnile a tswela pele re leboha hore ka jeno re ba pele ntate ba ile ba hopulwa ha re dumelang ke a tsamaya ke a lefatsheng lela le modimo a ntukiseditseng lona re a leboha modimo dingata hakakang tse re ka di bolelang empa gobane dingata ga re na go qeta re tlisa diteboho le ditanki nka re le ba lelapa ga ba utlwa bohloko ba ka gopola ntho tse ntle tsa di entseng e be ba tshidiseha mina thoko o re qetang go utlwa gona jwale o re ga gona bohloko bo leng teng lefatsheng bo modimo a kekeng a bo fodisa re a tia ke mantswe ao re a leboga kreste o phelang mme rona re qetelela ka gore morena ga o rialo re ka belaela jwang o itse re se ka ba ra tshaba o tla ba le rona o na le rona morena o na le famili o na le batho bohle e mmakatsang fela ntate kore na is it a coincidence hore ka letsatsi le re utlwang gore o tsamaile mo ne re tshwantse re phatlalle re founelane re etseng go plenilwe letsatsi le tshwanang le gore re tle re tlo bokana re re tsamaye hantle ntata rona ke ne ke mmitsa ntate I will miss him I will so miss him. Empa yena ha re sheba outram music o are manyeloi a matle a hwehla a mpitsa a nkisa ho morena. Ntate re ka belaela jwang. Re a leboha morena. Re a leboha Modimo o phelang. Wa bona la hore le rona o tla sala o na le rona. Robala ka khotso. Robala ka khotso tata rona. Go bile monate go phela le wena, go bile monate go tseba, re a leboga Modimo o phelang, le bitsong le maatla la Kriste Jesu. Amen.
God is good all the time. I just want someone who is here to sing with me. And we say, Morena, if we may stand, Yeah. My last one as I bid farewell to time. My last one as I say to Mama, the Bantwana and the whole family, to twin. Allow me to say, Ali Pirimele. Unde ya boroko ne aboro ke lala ke lala ke motsepe tate ya lerato Tango bobele o sineka ubunwe opa 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 aba koko onzayo o kuta Osipata, osipata ngobubele, osinika, osinika, aubungwe, opa, 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 aba. Tamsa nga, I tamsa, tamsa nga, eliku.
Tamsanga, Tamsanga, Aelesu, Liko, 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 Kote.
Clever, dear Tama. Sit on your handless son, there's no more honey. Whoever chose to gift us with this picture for this service couldn't have gifted us with any better future. I mean, picture. I'm going for this service only to say, what a gentleman. I kill a gentleman. Kill a gentleman, or mono, utsurumutuai. Time is coming, we will tell you. Different people will tell you about the different facets of his life. We will revel in his biography. This is a taste of testimonies that are going to be shared. We thank God for this wonderful life. We're still going to talk about him. And so, the notice of his death comes at a time when I was in an interview telling researchers about this concept in the Methodist Church called the connection, telling them our head office is not called Methodist head office, it's called the Methodist Connectional Office. And I was telling the researchers, it's because our polity, our structure, our ethos is we are connected. We are connected throughout the six countries that make up the Methodist Church of Southern Africa. We are connected through the 15 districts, the circuits. We are people who in our souls are supposed to be connected. And we are connected with God, and we are connected with Brati. I say this because as we gather here, we are connected with his friends overseas. And I know Eileen in Washington, D.C. has mobilized and connected others of our friends. He used to sing in Eileen. Eileen is a professor of music and was teaching at Wesley Seminary in D.C. And Brati sang in her choir. And all those people who used to come here, most of them were singing in Eileen's choir. And so there couldn't have been a proper and a best way to celebrate his life than through music. And so we take this time to thank all the connection, Methodist and non-Methodist, the connection for traveling with Brati in his last mile of the way until at this moment. We are inviting all of us to join in whatever manner and ways God has gifted us, whether it's through music and prayer, to lift up Siskidi and the children. Sis Binia and Brazweli and the other siblings and the entire clan, that we lift them up until we lay him to rest. You can see that I'm struggling to say until we lay him to rest. We will tell you stories about faith, spiritual, no, let me speak proper English, bizarre sounding kinds of decisions he has made, to the point that when we say we're going to lay him to rest, we need to get our language right. We will tell you, and it is very interesting. I said, Brazilian, I'll repeat this when I speak at another time. It took long for the doctors. They did their level best. And this is my prayer and my wish. I hope out of their struggles, and I was saying to Ngaland and to Bosi, that they have learned lessons that they will go and benefit others. During this time, I hope it was, and I don't want to use the word experiment, but I hope they have drawn lessons that they will document and go and help, because that is what Brati wanted. So we are not shaken by what has happened, because he wanted his body to be a resource for medical education, and we will tell you more. And so we invite us to be in prayer. We are going to, when we part here, there are eats that the local church has organized, and we will mingle. We will give Sis Kitty and family hugs. From here, we want to, there are people who have been uncomfortable with this work that I'm doing, but it is over strong. We will give the family space. I know Africans struggle with this one, but we will give the family space this evening to go and meet at home, so that this is still fresh to say, where are we going? What is it that we want done? How are we going to celebrate him? And then they will invite us. And my responsibility is to assemble my colleagues in the ministry, so that from our side we'll meet, and I will indicate probably around 12 in the office tomorrow, having heard what the family is thinking, and then see where we fit in, what support role, what solidarity, what accompaniment, what pastoral responsibilities we together have. We will appreciate that there are many layers of connections, church, social, family, and so on, that we need to connect. And so we will find each other and find a befitting way of ministering to the family and celebrating the life until we lay him to rest. Let us cooperate around that. The place where they stay is in Dawyaba Pumli, pensioners, small space. We'll find ways where we do not close, but we do not also crowd. because it is a gated, these spaces. But we will find ways of how to celebrate him so that nobody. The series Mubango on TV is of people who fight, African people who fight around funerals. Let there be no Mubango. We're going to celebrate. This is somebody who is very strict, is somebody who's meticulous, is somebody who has protocol. And so we will find ways and create space for all of us to feel that we have contributed. Today, Sis Mujaji was our mission, district mission coordinator, the lady who just prayed. We had invited Cheryl, who worked as a secretary with Brati for a long time, to do prayers. She was prepared to pray until she had Brati had passed on. She said no, because they were very close. So we'll find and create space for all of us. I just want to celebrate and thank my colleagues that agreed for me to do what is uncharacteristic in the church of a bishop who gives directives and instructions, and they cooperate knowing that it is not for the bishop's sake, but it is for the sake of the glory of God. And let us cooperate around this. Thank you very much for coming to this service. Thank you, thank you. I am not a person who struggles with words, but I'm searching for words. But God will carry us through. Thank you very much, Ngalonde. Mind here again. Here for now. Thank you very much. When do we do the benediction now or after? After? Let's celebrate and we'll do the benediction.
Na ki boma ba use ni di bo ba tu tu la u ba li se di ba li se di ba.
Say the benediction in English, and we invite those who are connected through live stream to join us wherever in the world you are. By the way, we have also informed the General Secretary and the presiding bishop, and we will also facilitate harmony with that connectional office with our leadership. And now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. you are invited. And even those at home, please do virtually join us as we. Thank you.